As 1,000 kids go 1,000 directions each morning at Southeast Guilford High School.
Well, howdy doody.
Caitlin Little
appears
not to be going anywhere at all.
Although it seems like this has been going on forever.
She's in my honors class first block, so I see her first during the day.
Has she got a turtle?
Yeah.
She'll show up in Mrs. Smith's classroom on time, but she doesn't show up.
Is this vocab?
Hold.
Wait, what is this unit on?
My heart breaks for Caitlin. Because she is such a delight. And I just hate to see her and her family going through this.
16 months ago, Caitlin got hit in the head as she was running a cross-country practice at school.
From what I understand, the way it occurred, it wasn't something that, you know, was premeditated, pre-planned. It was just an accident that happened.
But it left Caitlin with a brain injury that produced a form of amnesia, where her brain resets every night as she sleeps. Erasing everything from the day before.
I try to tell her what the temperature is going to be, whether it's raining or not.
Hey, sweetheart.
What the, you know, the day of the week is usually.
Hey, today is January the 16th. It's about 25 degrees out. It's got about 50 degrees today. You have a journal. It explains things over here on your desk.
Every day she wakes up, Caitlin thinks it's the day after the accident. It's October 13th, 2017.
In the first few weeks, you know, maybe a month after the accident, I would tell her, hey, you know, you hit your head doing cross-country practice and, you know, you've been out of school for a while. But I had to stop that after about the first few weeks or a month because anybody can deal with an issue that's been a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks. But after you get to the point where you're saying, well, Caitlin, it's been, you know, a month. Caitlin, it's been 2 months. It's just too much to take in right when you wake up.
She seems to get it because even though her mind tells her it's still 2017.
But then I look around, I'm like, things are different. Yeah. So if the facts line up with what he says, then I say, okay, I guess that's how it is. It's not easy, but.
It's posted right there by the desk that she uses each day, a summary of what happened in October of 2017. And even though it emphasizes that she's come a long way since then.
So I can't imagine every morning how she shifts gears. Okay, so it's 16 months later. I don't even need to worry about that.
Daniel, did you sleep like last night?
So as the rest of the family gathers for breakfast.
How'd you sleep, Caitlin?
Caitlin's adjustment to the light and noise is slow and often painful.
Don't know? Okay.
When you have no memory, your life becomes scripted.
Can I show you a little checklist we have real quick for you? To help you know that you've taken the right vitamins, go ahead and check off that you took all your breakfast vitamins.
Everything in their household is labeled.
I've sort of told a couple people, that's like living in Alice in Wonderland, because in there they have eat me, drink me, use this. And that's all of her sticky notes everywhere. It's just use this, wear this, you really like this. And it's sort of just what you do.
Caitlin's life scripted on Post-its.
So I have lots of Post-it notes that say, hey, that's do this, or this is new, or things to help me out, so it's not as hard as I'd imagine it'd be without them.
Messages from the mundane to the instructive. Don't wear your big sister's shirts. It gets on her nerves. They laugh when they can.
You want help carrying stuff?
Because it's the only way to stop from crying. What can be routine for most.
Yes, ma'am.
Taken for granted.
This school, did that move your classroom or anything?
No, my classroom did not move. Good question.
She has to relearn every day.
Yeah, I'm thinking of what I want to do today at my mom's school.
Trapped, at least for now, in a never-ending cycle.
I'm not sure how I got here, but I know that I am here. Which is hard to accept, but there's nothing I can do about it.